Hi there, welcome to the channel, or welcome back to the channel if you've been here before. If you're watching this as these are being published, it is now February of 2024, and February is a short month, so this month I am going to be focusing on some short, quick tips and wins for you. So, we're going to start off with a great new feature that Squarespace has recently added to enable so much more functionality and flexibility in how you can edit your navigation bar in your website. So if we haven't met yet, my name's Meg. I'm a yoga meditation teacher turned Squarespace web designer, and I'm here to help you elevate your business and your website without the tech overwhelm. So before, editing your site header wasn't terribly difficult. Multi-step process, one interface, not a lot of design flexibility that you could customize a lot of things, but it is what it is. Well, they've recently released a new update to how you edit your site header, and I think it's a great step forward. There's a couple little bit of learning curves if you're used to the old way that you kind of be like, where did this section go and how do I edit this now? So I'm going to cover all of that in this video, and you're going to love it, I'm sure. So let's go over to my demo site and I'll show you how it works. All right, so this new way of editing your header is pretty cool. A little bit of a learning curve, but it actually makes things a lot easier than it was before and gives you a little bit more flexibility to treat elements separately. So let's take a look. I'm in edit mode here and on my demo site, and let's just go in here and you'll see you still have what you're used to and pops up the edit site header. But when I click this, what you'll see is I'm getting different elements highlighted separately. And then I also have this edit design button and an add elements. So they've broken this all up. Let's start with edit design. Edit design is what you might be used to, but this is where you can decide what logo, navigation, and button spacing you want to have, and you can play around with that to your heart's content. And you can also play around with the link spacing. So this is, as you'll see as I move this larger, the space between the social icons and the items on my navigation menu get wider or smaller. The element spacing, you can see that as well. Now this isn't moving the individual social links, but it's spacing out all of them in relation to the logo and the button. So things you can play with there. You have the ability now, and this is really cool, you can add a drop shadow, which you can't see very well in this example because I have a picture down below, but you can do some blurring. You can choose all different kind of options here. So you can do a drop shadow for an effect. My personal favorite is now being able to add a border to your header. So you can choose a color for it. You can choose how thick it is. You can even customize that. And the position, whether you want the border all the way around, top or bottom, just the top or just the bottom. You used to have to do this with code, and now you don't have to anymore. So really nice new feature there as well. And that's simple to just, you know, toggle on off. You can change to fixed position or not. That we used to have before, but now that's all here. You can play with the height of your header, which this I think is a cool feature. So you can make it super thin if you want, but gives you a lot more flexibility in how you want that to show. Again, keeping in mind that anything you do on the header is going to translate to all of your other pages. So make sure that whatever you're doing, you're comfortable and works with the design that you're having on all your other pages as well. And then you can choose full or an inset here as well. This is also where you can choose your color themes. Nothing new here. Same options that you had before. Gradient, a solid color, which then pulls, you know, from which theme you want to use. You can kind of choose that now. Not a lot of differences here. You can do some opacity here. You can do blurring a background, but lots of fun little design options you have here. So that's the overall design. Now, if we want to, we can add elements. So over here is where you kind of toggle on or off what you want included in header. So do I want a button or not? Do I want the social links to appear or not? If you have a store, do you want a cart to appear? Do you want a login for an account, which you would enable here as well, but you could have a login if you have that. And also if you use WeGlot, you could throw that in there if you have a multilingual site, so you can have those things in there. So this, you know, determines what elements you're going to have. And now I can edit these individually. So my navigation menu, if I edit that, this is pretty much just the content. Now for, you know, whatever order you had your pages listed in your main navigation on the left-hand side is what they would show up as, and you can still drag and drop, move things around there. But now you have the ability to move things around like this, and you can show pages as well. So again, so you can still do what you used to do here. You could still drag and drop here and it'll work. But now we just have that option of being able to do so right within the header in the edit mode. Coming over to the button, we can manage the link to our button. We can manage the content here, so whatever the text you wanted to have, you also have the link is listed here as well, and the design, so you can decide which type of button you want to use here. And your social links, you can also edit at right in here, so you can choose from a design perspective the size of your icon and a little bit about the style. You can play with that right here within the header. And your content, you can list this right here. Also, it'll automatically show up if you already have listed or set up your social links in your connected accounts as well. You can edit, you can delete, you can drag and drop, change the order of them. Everything right within here. You can add another social link from in here as well if you like. So pretty cool in that you can affect these individually. Now, saving what I think is kind of the best last is your site title and logo. You can go in here, and this is where you have your site title, just as you had before, and where you can add a logo image if you want to actually have a graphic logo up here. You still also have the ability to upload a separate logo for your mobile view as well, if you like. So that's pretty much in a nutshell. Still all the same functionality for the most part that you had before, with some added functionality as well. Some great design elements being added in there with the borders and things like that. So you have a lot more design flexibility and things to play around with in your header now, and the ability to address things individually. So take a little bit of getting used to, but I think this is a great update and will really give you the ability to make your header much more dynamic and much more special for your website. It's really great to see them adding these new functionality and design elements that we can use now without having to do any code. So you can really personalize your website without having to have any technology whatsoever. Thanks so much, and I'll see you again soon.